400 kilometers above the Earth, ESA astronaut Thomas Pesquet is exercising. He's nearing the end of his first space flight, a six-month stay on board the International Space Station. Without this daily routine, microgravity would by now have substantially weakened his body. Prior to the mission, named Proxima, Thomas spent many months training with the International Space Station partners. Traveling between Europe, Japan, Russia, and the USA, there was a plethora of new skills to learn before he was ready to represent ESA in orbit. In November 2016, Thomas was transferred to Baikonur in Kazakhstan to get ready for the launch, alongside crewmates Peggy Whitson from NASA and Russian cosmonaut Oleg Novitsky. As the Soyuz launcher was prepared for liftoff, the traditional schedule of pre-flight formalities took place before the crew shared a few final words with the world's press.
It's coming, the rocket is ready, everything's ready, the crew is ready, so there's still a few boxes to tick, but very small ones, until we tick the very big one tomorrow evening. It's going to take the launch of the rocket and feeling the G's and getting to orbit for me to really realize that, yes, my dream has finally come true and I'm going to space.
The crew was launched on November the 17th, their Soyuz MS-03 capsule reaching the ISS 2 days later. It was the first time a French astronaut had set foot on board the station since 2008, when Leopold Aerts helped to install ESA's Columbus laboratory. Over the last few months, Thomas Pesquet has worked on a program of around 50 experiments for ESA and CNES, and others for the station's international partners. In studies ranging from human physiology to fluid physics, the station's unique microgravity environment continues to be an invaluable resource to scientists back on Earth. As flight engineer, he's also been responsible for keeping the station operational. This has included taking part in docking procedures for the station's supply vehicles, namely the Japanese HTV and American SpaceX Dragon. There have also been maintenance tasks to perform outside the station. So far, Thomas has carried out two spacewalks under the direction of veteran ESA astronaut Luca Parmitano from Mission Control in Houston. On January the 13th, he upgraded the station's batteries during a six-hour operation with NASA astronaut Shane Kimbra. The pair ventured outside once more in March, with Thomas checking for leaks in the cooling system and maintaining the Canadian two-armed robot. Like all of ESA's long-duration missions, Proxima has been an opportunity to inspire future scientists and astronauts back on Earth. This is the Zero Robotics Tournament, where students get the chance to submit programs to control satellites on board the ISS. As expected, it's been an extremely busy few months for Thomas. There has, however, been the odd moment of downtime, a precious chance to enjoy the view from the station's cupola windows. It'll soon be time to enter the Soyuz capsule and begin the journey home, leaving ESA's Paolo Nespoli to take his place amongst the space station's permanent crew.